Hi there. In this tip, I'd like to show you guys a really quick way of applying textures to, let's just say, NURBS objects that have caps and rounding. Typically, when we apply a material to an object in Cinema 4D, we just drag the texture tag on like this, and if there's any sort of texturing to be done, we apply the mapping and the different methods that we might employ. But what if an object has caps and rounding like this one does? Just to make my point, I'm going to go in here and tweak it a little bit. So I have some Motex, and I have caps on the front only. And if I change this, I can change it from one step to linear or concave. So let's do concave. So what we have here is text with a bunch of concave caps. Now, if we wanted to apply different materials to that, you might think that we have to convert it to an editable object. But what if we wanted to keep it as non-editable so we could edit the text if we wanted to? Well, there's actually a way to get the best of both worlds if you're just dealing with the caps and the rounding. Here's how it works. Cinema 4D has these internal polygon selections for caps and rounding. So typically a polygon selection, for instance, on a sphere, might work after you convert it to an editable object. So if this sphere was converted to an editable object, we can now select polygons. And if I were to use the live selection tool, I can actually select a polygon selection like that. And then I can go up to, I believe it's the select menu, and say set selection. We now have a selection tag that we can give a name. So I can call this tag 1. If we applied the orange material to the sphere, and then applied the brownish-red material as well, we can restrict this brownish-red material to this selection by dragging the selection tag in. So that's really great, but it requires that you convert the object to a polygonal object. And there's a way to get around that as long as you're dealing with NURBS objects like any of these generators here, lathe, sweep, loft, extrude, or the text objects. And there are simply built-in selections that you can choose. For instance, if I were to drag this orange material and then in the selection say C1, it's going to apply it just to the caps, the first caps of the object. If I were to add a second set of caps to the back of the object, it's not applied, because what I would need to do is drag another material on and need to restrict it to C2. So C2 has the red material, C1 has the orange material, and the hull, or the rest of the object, has this yellow material. So if I wanted to mess up the colors a little bit more, I could create something awful like this green material. And I can then apply the green material to the object as well. And I can restrict it to R1 for rounding 1. And I can just replicate this tag and restrict that to R2. For rounding too. And it doesn't just have to be solid colors either. You can do this with different sorts of materials. For instance, I can create a checkerboard pattern and apply that to the object, and then I can apply checkerboard pattern to R1. And then we can probably change this to flat mapping and just grab our texture tool. We can scale it down a bit. So now we have that sort of dashed line on the caps. So there's definitely a lot of cool things that you can do with this. Of course, I've managed to make the ugliest text in the world, but you can use it a lot more intelligently than I have here. The coolest part about this is that this is all live. Nothing has been converted to a polygonal object. You can come in here and change the angle of the spline to make the text lower or higher quality. You can change the text. You can apply MoGraph deformers and other sorts of objects. So I just thought this was a nice tip. It's really helpful doing, you know, simple logo animations and silly stuff where you want the text to be changing, but you also want to have different materials on different parts of the text object. So that's all. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and until next time, see ya.